गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर हेलो डॉक्टर सेशन इन सुश्रुत टीवी। टुडे वी हैव विद अस डॉक्टर स्वाति कुमारी फ्रॉम सुश्रुत आई फाउंडेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर। गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, वेलकम टू आवर शो। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट केमिकल इंजरी इन आई। इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी और सजेशन, प्लीज कॉल अस। फोन नंबर इज 9073997720। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन। The first of all is, what are the chemical injuries?
Actually, chemical injuries, there are various things which can accidentally fall into our eyes, like our daily house cleaning agents, or the refrigerants, or the car washing agents, all those things, even in the certain batteries also.
Okay.
So, if those things get exploded or it gets spilled in your eyes, all these causes chemical injury to your eyes.
Okay, and what are the modes of these chemical injuries?
It can happen, basically we categorize chemical injury into various agents. It could be either a acid, it could be either a alkali or a toxins. So we have certain, like we say ki alkali injuries are more dangerous compared to acid injury, because alkalis, what they do, they penetrate deeper into the tissue and causes more damage. But when we talk about acid will go on the surface and it will coagulate over there and it stays there. So the penetration and the depth of injuries by the acid is less. So while somebody is cleaning a toilet, those things contain alkali. Somebody is polishing a car, it contains acid. It can, you know, and the car batteries you have, it has sulfuric acid. So all those things, you can accidentally, it can fall into your eyes and cause chemical injury. So these are the modes. You can get in your home also, in your workplace also.
And how do you treat a chemical injury patient?
Chemical injury patient, like, present to us in the various formats. Like, it could be a minimal injury, just presenting to us like a simple redness of the eye, and patient will come and complain like he's having photophobia, watering, redness, that's all, to the major total ocular destruction also. So it varies, and our treatment also varies depending upon what kind of injury the patient has attained. Okay, if it is more severe, we have to manage it in different way. But if it is a less severe injury, we have to manage it in other way.
Okay. Doctor, if a patient having a chemical injury, then what are the immediate measures taken by the patient?
Immediately, as soon as the patient sustain a chemical injury, the best thing is to avoid the chemical agent. Mm-hmm. Like he or she should be, if the patient has any bystanders or patient himself, they should try to isolate themselves from the area where they have attained the chemical injury. And the second most important thing is to start washing their eyes. We prefer using BSS or normal saline, but if nothing is available, the patient will definitely, they will not have this at their workplace or home. So they can use a regular tap water also. Okay. And they should give a thorough wash to their eyes till they reach the hospital. And even if they are using an ambulance to come to the hospital or anything, they should keep washing their eyes.
Okay.
While coming to the hospital, if they are able to see ki there is any offending agent fallen into the eye, if they are able to pick it up by themselves, they should try to take it off.
Okay.
And, but the most important thing is, as soon as you sustain an injury, wash your eyes on the way throughout, like from your home or workplace to the hospital, and come to the hospital immediately.
Okay. And can a chemical injury recover?
Well, that is what I'm saying. Like, it depends ki what is the extent of the injury.
Okay.
If the injury is of minimal grade, like we have a different grades of injury, we categorize it for our treatment preference. So if it is a minimal injury, like simple redness or a little bit of epithelium, your upper layer of the cornea is aberrated, that patient will definitely recover within a week time. But if it is a very devastating conditions, like the whole lid has burned out, or if suppose the cornea, like we have three, basically with chemical injury, our eyelids get affected. Eyelids, your cornea get affected, your conjunctiva, the white portion, what you see. So once that area, the between the, your cornea and the conjunctiva, we have a junction. If that junction is lost, it is very difficult for our cornea to recover.
Okay. And what are the complications of this kind of patient?
These patients will have, apart from symptoms, if you talk about the immediately, these patients they can end up with glaucoma. They can end up with dry eye. They have post chemical injury sequelae, like they can have their upper eyelid get stick to the whiter portion of the eye, which we call bulbar conjunctiva and palpebral conjunctiva. in our terms we call it as ankyloblepharon and simblepharon, or the two eyelids can get stick together also. That might also happen. Sometimes the lower lid gets everted outside, or upper lid gets everted or inverted also.
Okay.
So all these things can occur.
Okay. Can a patient, like chemical injury patient, go blind?
Yeah, it is a possibility.
And what kind of percentage of this kind of patient?
Like, it is very rare. It is very rare, but it does happen. If the chemical injury can make you blind.
Okay. And any kind of precautions or risk factor?
Precautionary wise, actually, in our country, we don't follow the safety measures. That is the problem. Because every OPD, I get one or two patients of chemical injury.
Okay.
So, while working in a workplace where you know you are dealing with a various kind of chemical, it is always advisable, like it should be made a rule that they should all wear the protective measures, like a goggles or a helmet, something like that, so that they can prevent the chemical falling into their eyes. That is for the people who are working in the factory or in their workplace. And if you are going for your normal household routine cleaning work, when you want to, you are using a toilet cleaner or something else like dye, or even the patient, the people who are working with this, what do you call that? Whitewash and all those people. So that is a one of the very most common thing, which they come with that chuna falling into their eyes, right? So those persons should always wear goggles while working with those things. Even if you want to clean your toilet, my request will be please wear glasses, because if accidentally also it spills into your eyes, it can lead to a devastating conditions also.
Okay. Or any kind of suggestion for our viewers, ma'am?
That's what we try. Precaution, prevention is better than cure. So while working with or handling any kind of chemicals, please take care of your eyes. They are very precious. Take care, use protective, proper protective measures. And in case accidentally you attain any kind of injuries, please report to hospital immediately.
Okay.
And wash your eyes like throughout the way before coming to hospital also. And come immediately to us.
Okay. Thank you so much, doctor. And
thank
also our viewers for being with us. Today's session is stopped here. Thank you so much. We will see you soon.